Hello, welcome to this how-to video. My name is Andrea Schumann. I'm a support architect for SAP Cloud ALM. In this video, I will demonstrate how to set up integration and exception monitoring for SAP SuccessFactors in SAP Cloud ALM. During the setup, I will show you which prerequisites you need to fulfill in SAP SuccessFactors, how to activate the push data collection in the SAP SuccessFactors tenant, how to create an endpoint for the pull data collection in SAP Cloud ALM, and how to activate the data collection for integration and exception monitoring. For integration and exception monitoring, SAP Cloud ALM uses push and pull data collection to collect all necessary data. For the pull data collection, you need a user with specific authorizations in SAP SuccessFactors. This user should not be a personal user or an admin user, but rather be created specifically for the use in the endpoint from SAP Cloud ALM. You find a full list of the required settings and permissions for this user in the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert portal under Integration and Exception Monitoring Details, SAP SuccessFactors, Setup Steps in SAP SuccessFactors, Create a User for SAP SuccessFactors Monitoring. A link to the expert portal is provided in the description of this video. To make sure that the provided user has the correct permissions, you can use the tool View User Permission in the Admin Center of SAP SuccessFactors. Search for the SFAPI user that was provided for you. Use the link View Permission to see all permissions assigned to the user. The push data collection is triggered in SAP SuccessFactors and sends monitoring data to SAP Cloud ALM. To be able to set up the push data collection, make sure that your own user has the following authorization. Manage integration tools, access to Integration Service Registration Center UI. To set up the push data collection in SAP SuccessFactors, go to the admin tool Integration Service Registration Center. Select SAP Cloud ALM from the drop-down list. In the field System Type, enter the system role of your SAP SuccessFactors tenant. You can use Dev, Test, or Prod. Enter a short description. This description will be displayed in the Landscape Management in SAP Cloud ALM in the field Description. Under Monitoring Service Details, you need to enter the information from the SAP Cloud ALM service key. The endpoint URL is the value of the parameter API without the trailing /API. The OAuth URL is the value of the parameter URL extended by /OAuth/token. Enter the client ID and the client secret from the SAP Cloud ALM service key. Click the Register button to trigger the registration. After the registration is finished, the field Service ID will contain the ID of the SAP SuccessFactors service in SAP Cloud ALM's Landscape Management. This concludes the setup steps in SAP SuccessFactors. Now we get to the setup in SAP Cloud ALM. To be able to perform all necessary setup tasks, you will need the role Integration Monitoring Integration Architect in your SAP Cloud ALM tenant. First, I will create an endpoint for the pull data collection. This is done in the Landscape Management application. You find the Landscape Management app in the group Administration. Open the Landscape Management app. Your SuccessFactors tenant should already be available in the Landscape Management, as it is automatically imported from the System Landscape Information Service at SAP. If it wasn't already imported, it would have been created during the Push Data Collection registration. Click on the Name or the Details button for your SAP SuccessFactors tenant. On the tab Endpoints, click the Add button to add a new endpoint. Enter an endpoint name and the description. Select Exception Monitoring as use case for this endpoint. The root URL is automatically copied from the Cloud Service Information in the Landscape Management. You have to adjust the root URL so it points to the API URL for the SAP SuccessFactors tenant. To find out which URL you have to use, check SAP Note 221-5682, in which you find the SAP SuccessFactors API URLs for the different data centers. If you don't know your data center, you can use SAP Node 277-6694 to find out where your tenant is located. Select Basic Authentication as Authentication Type. Enter the username and the password of the SFAPI user in SAP SuccessFactors. Enter the username as username@companyid. You can use the Check Connection button to see if your connection works. Save your endpoint. This concludes the setup steps in Landscape Management. The last step is to activate the pull data collection categories for the SAP SuccessFactors service. This is done in the Integration and Exception Monitoring application. You find this application in the group SAP Cloud ALM for Operations. Open Integration and Exception Monitoring. To be able to activate the data collection, you need to add the SAP SuccessFactors service to the scope of Integration and Exception Monitoring. Open the scope selection. Select the SAP SuccessFactors service. Click Apply. Now open the configuration pane by clicking the RegWheel icon in the upper right corner. The push data collection is automatically activated during the push monitoring registration, but you still have to activate the pull data collection. Click on the service name. Click on the service name once more. Activate the data collection for the exception categories which you want to collect. The correct endpoint should be selected automatically. Save your changes. This concludes the standard setup for integration and exception monitoring. Thank you for watching this video. You now know how to set up integration and exception monitoring for SAP SuccessFactors with SAP Cloud ALM. For further information regarding the technical setup, feel free to consult the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert Portal, which is continuously updated with the latest news. A link to the Expert Portal is provided in the description of this video.